Most men can't raise their voice. They can't raise their voice at their job, they'll get fired. They can't raise their voice in their house. The woman's gonna be like, who the fuck you yelling? Most men are going through life putting on a face they don't wanna put on, saying things they don't wanna say, repeating things they don't believe. And we all know that lies are a sin, gentlemen. Yeah. And you are lying to yourself and everyone around you. I live with true intent. If I tell you I like you, I like you. If you come up to me on the street and I'm like, oh, hey, G, I wish the best for you. I wish the absolute best for you. If I dislike you and I punch you in the face, I meant it. Now, I live with complete true intent. I have a pure heart. And I believe that's more important. That's something that's so valuable. Most men don't even know how that feels.
I probably do maybe 1,000, about 1,000 push-ups a day I try and get through. But that's like when I'm on the computer or I'm watching TV. As soon as there's a I program my mind. Like if an advert comes on or if I've sent an email, I make myself do 20 or 30 push-ups.
When I was a kid and I was a chess player and I was winning, my dad always encouraged me to brag. Said, yeah, you won. Go brag. Tell him you won. This is the real world. You won. Only losers are going to be upset when winners talk. I'm not saying go through life and be completely unlikable. But if you wake up every day and you look in the mirror and say, you know what? I'm the man. Who out there can do more than what I can do? If you really believe that in yourself, then what's going to happen is you're going to feel motivated to prove it. You have to have a mental disorder to have an ego with no justification. But if you're going to wake up every day and work your ass off and make money and buy cars and train and be in fantastic physical shape to prove your ego. So when someone comes along and goes, well, what's your problem? You say, I ain't got a problem. My life's good.
Why do men cheat? Most women don't know. You'll see them all the time. Why do men cheat? Oh, because men are just stupid. And why do men fuck girls uglier than their main chick? Why do men do all this stuff? Do you know why? I'll tell you why. State it. Yeah, that's my chick. She's home. Took this one home. Yeah, I got that one. She's chasing me. State it. But it's stupid to females. I get it. But that's the male world.
I'll give the game away to the entire YouTube world why I've destroyed absolutely everybody in any debate ever. I say things that they know are true and that they agree with, but I say it in a way that angers them emotionally. And they get caught up in their brain. So instead of saying men are physically stronger than women, I'll say females are weak. Females are weak. Well, females are weak. Well, some women are strong like men. Trying to argue the fact that women are as strong as men physically because I've emotionally controlled them all and upset them all.
If my chick said, I want to do OnlyFans, I'm like, all right, then cool, go do it. How much you make? 10 grand, or give me 8.
Why would, what woman is going to give you 8 grand?
Next question.
No.
That upset her, didn't it?
People, when I got banned, said, well, we don't want people to end up like Tate. And I said, why? I have no criminal record, no criminal convictions, successful, hundreds of millions of dollars, dedicated. Like, what would be so bad if men ended up a version of me? Like, what am I going to do to the world?
Andrew, how would you deal with a follower that doesn't like you?
I would accept that him disliking me is my fault. I would be a man about it, and I would ask him what he's unhappy about, and he might be fucking right. I'd sit there and go, what do you dislike about?
So just confront the dad.
Not confront in a negative way. I just say, look, I'm here with your daughter. I really care about her. I get the impression that you're not particularly happy with me. Is there anything I can do? I just want to show you respect. You're a bit older than me. I want to show you enough respect to ask if there's anything about me that particularly upsets you. Because he'll respect you more. Men respect men who stand up for themselves.
Yeah, 100%.
So the first thing he'll do is respect you more for even asking instead of hiding away from the dude.
If you say in a respectful way.
And then he'll give you a bunch of answers. And then you have to be non-emotional and be professional. Listen to the answers. Don't get defensive and sit there and go, you know what? 70% of them are probably fucking right.
Female life is more valuable than male life. If someone comes in this door with a gun, we are prepared to die to protect you. We would die on the Titanic so the women could live. If we talk about 5 men dying in a car crash, no big deal. If you talk about 5 women dying in a car crash, it's a big deal. Female life is super valuable, and you are super valuable members of society, and you have something very, very important to do. You're so important that we'll go put ourselves on the line and take all the responsibility. When we say we are leading, I'm not trying to degrade females. I know you get triggered instantly because you live in a Western society where you feel like that's an insult. We're not trying to insult you. We're saying that it's a man's job to lead. He can't protect and provide if he isn't leading.
Every fighter who fights long enough knows it's much worse to get hit here than get hit in the face.
If you eat one of them properly, it's like money in the bank. You hit in the first round and you feel it in round 5. It just fucking hurts forever. They know it's coming, they can prepare. But if you catch them like on a counter or you catch them with the breathing in or something, it's like,
I've been rocked in the face before. So I know what that feels like, but I'm not being properly. I'm not saying I want it.
I had a girl who did self-defense classes. This is like a couple years ago. She goes, oh, you're a kickboxer. I want to show you like my self-defense. And if you grab me, I do this. I said, listen, all this female self-defense I can fight to is all bullshit. It's complete garbage. Female doesn't stand a chance against a man. A man who's genuinely enraged, you don't stand a chance. I'm sorry. The best thing you can do is scream and run.
What do you say if a guy was working a 9-to-5, married to a woman, had a couple of kids, going his 2 or 3 holidays a year, yep, and he said to you he was happy?
I'd say congratulations. I would genuinely say congratulations. If you're happy with that, And I know that's like a pretty normal setup. If you're happy with that, absolutely congratulations, and I don't look down on you. That's perfectly fine. But some men are just not born that way. Some men are born with something else inside of them, with a fire inside of them, which cannot be extinguished by beans on toast.
They put my ass in a cell. I'm sitting in the cell. A little side story. When I walk in, the guy who checks us all in is fat as fuck, right? No, fat, a real fat guy. And he asked me some question.
Okay, Andrew Tate, yeah, is that your name?
Yeah, you just said my name. Yeah, that's my name. Like, this guy's an idiot. So I got a little tiff with him back and forth. Anyway, he annoyed me. And he said, I just wanted to let you know that you're going to be monitored in the cell. If you have any ideas, I'm going to see him. What idea am I going to have in a cell, you dickhead? What am I going to do? So because he was a fat fuck, my idea in my cell was to do endless press-ups and teach him a lesson. I'm like the master of Wudan, like Dalsim. I'm sitting there, and I'm just sitting with my eyes closed, generating power from the universe, counting 60 seconds, 5 minutes, busting out 100 push-ups, 5 minutes, timing, 1, 2, 100 push-ups. And I was doing it knowing that this fat fuck is watching me, going, who the fuck is this dude? But I was in that cell for like 6 hours before my interview. Oh. And after a couple hours, I couldn't really do the push-ups anymore.
When's the last time we argued?
Last time me and you probably had a serious argument is when I was 17 years old. I was working night shift at Luton Airport. So Storm Gym, the place where me and Andrew learned to fight, the place where we honed our skills, runs from 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock PM for a couple hours. And that's when the training sessions were. So I was working night shift because I was making double the money, but I was starting work at 7, 8. And Andrew's saying, look, you got to get off night shifts. You got to get back on the day shift so you can come and train at Storm Gym. I was like, nah, man, I'm making twice as much money. Look, I'm making £400 a week making fucking sandwiches. Yeah, I've done bullshit jobs too. And Andrew said, no, you don't understand the importance of this training, the importance of being combat ready. And we had an argument, maybe 2 or 3 weeks, we had this severe disagreement, and I ended up turning off the night shifts and making less money going back on day shifts so I could then pay money to train. As an older man, I understand the value of this is worth more than any money I could have made.
I am fully aware that not everybody is going to agree with what I say. I don't think there's a person on the planet you can find who has a 100% approval rate. There's always going to be somebody who disagrees with what you say. If I said the earth was round, there would be a contingent of individuals on the planet who disagree with me. I have no problem with people disagreeing with me. I have no problem with being seen as controversial for some of the things I've said. However, I do have two significant problems I would like to address. The first is I do not like absolute and utter lies being told about me. I do not like having long form video of me cut up, elements taken out of context, the tonality of the joke removed, and purporting an image of me that's not true. That's something I do not like. I do not like false accusations of criminal activity. That's another thing that I really do not like. I am totally aware that not everybody is gonna like me. I have no problems with that. I think anyone who decides to get big on the internet needs to be very, very prepared for a contingent of people to not be happy with what they say.
I'm gonna tell you the most important things in life. First thing is health. You don't have shit if you're dead. The second thing is the health and respect of people you love, friends and family. The third most important thing is money. And it's money because money can buy you everything except the top two things. If you're not obsessed with money, then you're not obsessed with freedom. That's what money is. Money buys you freedom. Where am I? You don't need to know. The fact is I go wherever the fuck I want. All the time I wake up, I wanna go here, bang, I'm gonna go. It's not, oh, I can't go because I just go. I do what I like because I'm fucking rich. When I wanted to learn to kickbox, I went and found the best kickboxer I could. And I said, teach me everything you know. If you want to learn how to get rich, find the richest person you can think of and ask them how to get rich. If you know someone richer than me, just go talk to them. But you're not going to get rich on accident. You get rich on purpose with very specific habits, rituals, certain things you must do, things that rich people know and you do not know. It's time to learn.
The reason I don't like vape is because I don't think that vape is even remotely natural. Because a tobacco is a plant, okay, cool. But if you manage to put chemicals inside of a little container that tastes like blueberry ice, what even is blueberry ice? Yeah. I it's not even a flavor. It's just words. Yeah. And then you taste it and you go, that does taste like blueberry ice.
Yeah.
And
then they made it.
How did they pull that off? Yeah. I can't believe it's possibly good for me. Add in the price that it cost, add in the fact that it costs $1 and comes deep from the heart of China. Like you're like, yeah, you think they give a shit about the West just puffing away on this petrochemical? They don't care.
Yeah. It's 4 a.m. Club just ended. I was in a chicken and chip shop and there's a long line. An Audi with tinted windows pulls up. These 3 big black guys get out, push it straight in front of the whole line, go straight up to the front, cut in front of 5 people, start ordering. My girl goes to me, we've been waiting here ages. I said, shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up. Anyway, the man 2 in front of me, not this guy, the guy here, he couldn't tell his bitch to shut up.
approach. She's like, excuse me, there's a line. And the guy turns around and goes, do you think I don't see the fucking line? I don't care about a fucking line. She starts running her mouth. Bro, this dude knocked her the fuck out. Whack. Clean. Out cold. By the time her man looked at her and looked back up, boom. Spark. Done. Both of them. And I stood there and watched both of them just laid out clean. I wouldn't be surprised if they both had permanent damage. It was bad.